I'm gonna be trying all of these burgers in this video. And welcome to Sugar Spice Nice. My name is Shweta and in this video, I'm going to be indulging in burgers and fries. I realize that I've not really done any episode dedicated to burgers on this channel and the folks at Louis Burger, which is a newly launched burger chain in Mumbai, asked me if I wanted to try their burgers and I was like, yes. So I decided to try all of them along with you guys, share my first impression and what I really think about these. So without further ado, let's just straight get into the video. So they have a variety of veg and non-veg burgers, but what you're seeing here are all vegetarian. This is Jack in the Box, a plant-based burger made with jackfruit, pesto, herb tomatoes, scamorza, and mozzarella cheese. Then we have the vegan gratitude burger, and this is a power-packed indulgence with beet, beans, sweet potato, jalapenos, confit tomato, and vegan mayo. Then we have Farmhouse and it's got hot sauce, mozzarella, pink pickled onions and exotic veggies. Then we have the Herbivorous Burger. It's got a spicy sauce, a veg patty and lots of cheese. Then we have a limited edition Truffle Taco Burger. I think I'm pronouncing this correctly. I don't know. It's got shiitake mushrooms, truffle mayo, shimeji, truffle. It's got a lot of things inside. But the one thing that caught my eye was the gold work on top. Along with the burgers, they also sent me some peri peri fries and some cheesy fries, and the cheese sauce or fondue has come separate. Now, when I look at all of these burgers, there's one thing that instantly catches my eye. It's the sheer size of the burgers. These are pretty huge. They're not like your McDonald's or Burger King kind of burgers, but they are like an actual real big giant burger. The next thing that I notice is the buns. Now the buns have like this glaze all over, and when I touch the burgers, I realize that the buns are beautifully soft. I hope they're as soft when I actually give a bite into the burger, but right now they're just seeming so good. So I'm gonna go ahead and start trying each of these burgers. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to be trying is the Herbivorous Burger, and I wasn't kidding about the size. It's got a veggie patty inside, lettuce, some spicy sauce and cheese. It's feeling like a lot of potatoes. The patty has a crisp breadcrumb covering. The spicy sauce is honestly not so spicy, and if I'm saying it, then you know it's actually really not spicy. So this is like the layer of cheese on top, and that's the patty, and you can see the patty is pretty chunky and it's literally covering the burger end to end. The buns are not at all feeling dry. Many a times it happens that you're eating a burger and the bun is feeling so dry and bready almost. Like, it's not a very good feeling to have that, but this is a soft, a moist, well buttered bun, if I can say so. The mayo in this is very, very chatpata, and if you want to enjoy a more Indian, a desi flavored burger, then I would recommend you to try the Herbivorous one. Now the next thing that I have here is the vegan gratitude burger. I can see tomato, jalapenos, lots of lettuce. They say it's got vegan mayo. I can't see that much of it. And this patty is actually made from beans, sweet potato and beet. Now the inside of the burger is vegan and plant-based, but I don't know if the buns are vegan or not for this particular burger. So this feels heavy, like one bite and it gives that very full feeling. And you can see the patty here, it's a different colored one. It's got like traces of pink and stuff, which probably come from the beans and the beets. And overall, I feel this could have done with a little bit more mayo. The bun itself is not feeling dry, but when you like have it with the patty, you feel like a little bit of sauce is missing. At least that's what I felt. But I do have to say this, I'm really enjoying the jalapenos inside. Tomatoes as well, but jalapenos are adding such an amazing kick. Next I have here are their fries. I just decided to switch up the burgers and try the fries instead. And these are their peri peri fries. I am a little bit worried about trying these because I don't know how spicy they'll be, but let's just go ahead and try one. Mmm. They actually claim that their fries are 11mm thick. I don't know if that's accurate or not, but they are pretty chunky. Mmm. These are the kind of fries you have when you're just chilling, watching Netflix, and probably have some fizzy drink with you. Completely unhealthy, but probably good for the soul. I don't know. This is the Jack in the Box, which is the jackfruit burger, and I don't know if it's just me or the patty is looking bigger than the others. Like, it's just oozing out. So inside it's got lots of greens, pickled onions, tomatoes, and it's also actually got pesto and barbecue sauce, and it's got mozzarella cheese and also scamorza cheese, which is kind of like a fresh cheese. Let's try this ginormous burger. Okay, this patty is feeling very, very different. I don't know why, but the texture is pretty different. Crumbs and all are adding a great crunch to it, but it's got quite a bite, it's got quite a chew. And one bite of this and you know it's not your like regular veggie burger patty. Things made of jackfruit I feel end up being quite heavy because it's packed in fiber, and this is of course deep fried and stuff, so that's a different story. One thing that I do feel is that the pesto flavor is kind of overshadowed by the cheese, which works great for me. I'm not the biggest fan of pesto, so I'm fine with that. I think the flavor of pickled onion in a burger is just very, very interesting, and I feel like there should have been a lot more of that on top. In many places, jackfruit is also used as a replacement for a meat patty. I think if you're trying to go the vegan route, or you've like just switched from being a non-vegetarian to vegetarian, maybe you could try this. And if you like jackfruit, then yes, you can go ahead and try it. It's not like the flavor of jackfruit is that apparent, but I think the texture kind of gives it away. Alright, the next burger that I have here is the farmhouse. I think this is the most generously like topped with sauce and mayo and stuff. It has got hot sauce, pickled onion, lots of lettuce. All the burgers had a very, very generous amount of lettuce. So I don't know if this is the same patty as the Herbivorous patty. Some bits of it are feeling the same. But I think so far, this is like my most favorite burger, because I like everything in this. The patty is feeling amazing. The amount of cheese is feeling really, really good. The hot sauce is yum. The pickled onion, I would have of course liked a little more, but this is quite a good amount. And I can also feel like bits of jalapeno and stuff, which are honestly adding such an amazing flavor. Mmm. I think this patty maybe has more veggies. I really feel like there's lots of carrot in this. There's also cabbage probably, but I quite like this one. My recommendation would be farmhouse. Let's take a fry break and try their cheesy fries, and I'm not even going to say anything about the length of this fry. They do serve it with this cheese fondue, and it's just like a dip. These fries are already topped with something, you know, that you guys are going to laugh at me, but it's reminding me of the masala on cheese balls. I just reheated them, and warm fries dipped in this like thickish cheese sauce. Wow, I'm feeling so full right now. Now this episode has a grand ending, and the reason for that is this. This burger has gold. This is gold work, and this is not like the only fancy part about this burger. It's got lots and lots and lots of mushrooms. There's shiitake mushroom, truffle mayo, shimeji, which is also a kind of mushroom, truffle, English cheddar, parmesan, gold work, and truffle oil. I'm not the biggest fan of mushrooms, but I think I'm going to be trying like just one bite of this. So if you eat mushrooms, would you try out this burger? I don't think I've tried so many different varieties of burgers in one go ever, so thanks to the team of Louis for sending these to me. Most of the vegetarian ones are also priced pretty well, between 200 to 300 rupees. And the one with the gold work on top is, I think, about 700 rupees. And even the fries, they are about 180 rupees for the peri peri fries. And I think 220 or 230 rupees for the cheesy fries. There's one observation that I had about the buns is that they have like this very, very slight eggy aftertaste. I do eat eggs occasionally, so that wasn't a deal breaker for me. Sometimes even milk gives that kind of a feel to bread, and I did read that they are topped with milk while baking, so maybe it's that. So that was my experience from Louis Burgers. If you feel like trying a good chunky burger, then do check them out. I'm gonna leave links to them in the description box below, and I think they have only delivery. They don't offer dine-in, so you can find the delivery details as well in the description box below. That is really it from me. If you enjoyed this video, you know what you have to do. Hit that like button, share this video with all of your friends and family, and subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in my next video. Bye! Okay. The first thing that came to my mind when I saw all of this packaging was Louis! Louis!
Louis! Louis! Louis!
If you know, you know.